Alright, I'm Travis with the Midnight Ghost Hunters, and we're here tonight in Remington, Indiana at the historic Remington Water Tower. It was built in 1897. It's the only brick tower and wooden water tank in the state of Indiana. It's 104 foot tall, 20 foot in diameter. We're here tonight basically because this used to be the old Remington Town Hall and the clerk's office. So you would come here to pay your water bill for the town and whatnot. And we got called in because some of the reports from here, from the town clerk, and even people that would come in and pay their bill, they'd say that they'd see apparition of an elderly female woman, the smell of her perfume, a lilac scent in the mornings. They would hear doors shutting. I know the one report that we have had was a lady come in to pay her water bill, and then a couple weeks later her water got shut off at her house. She come in to find out why. They said they had no report or record of her paying the bill, and she had her check double, and it was stamped by the town seal or whatever. And they said, well, who did you speak to? And she says, well, I spoke to an elderly woman, probably in her late 70s. She had a bun in her hair, and she basically described this lady that they had reported seeing off and on by several different people. So the town council basically come to known to call her Aunt B, and a lot of reports have happened around here, so we thought it'd be a good place to do an investigation, and pretty soon you're going to check out all the footage and see what we caught. So watch close. Check stub or my blank or whatever, and it was stamped by the town's stamp, you know, town Remington paid. And and he's like, well, who did you speak to? And she says, I spoke with an elderly woman, kind of a, you know, bun in her hair, and she took my bill and said, stamped it, that it was paid, and I paid the bill. And the lady kind of was flipped out because that there's no elderly people that really work here. They're all, I mean, I don't want to say young, but, you know, anywhere between 30s to 50s. And the way this lady was describing, she was probably in her late 70s, early 80s. So, I mean, that's kind of weird.
But we don't know her name?
I think the town people that used to work in here before they built the new facility kind of called her Aunt B.
Aunt B?
Yeah. I don't know if that was just like the name that was given her to her, but, they said that they can smell the strong scents of like lavender or lilac. Which one was it?
Lilac.
Lilac perfume in the morning times.
And so, I mean, we should start there. I mean, that's our pretty much our best evidence so far.
Over here on this table by next to me is a little red light and a little green light. If you walk by
it, it just went off.
There it goes.
Keep asking questions.
Is that you? Okay, all right. You can stop it now.
Oh. That's hot. Can you try to stop lighting up those lights for us for a minute so we know it's you? Now, can you light those back up for us, maybe? Let us know that.
Please, that would be so cool if you could turn them back on. Or right here next to that is a little red light. If you would like to just say your name or what you'd rather have us call you, you can talk into that.
We came in here, it was 60.
I think, was that what it was?
It was 60.
60 degrees.
And now what's the temperature now?
54.8.
Okay. If you're still in here and you're lowering that temperature, if you could just walk by this little green light right here. I'll just put it to that end of the table. Just walk right by it. That is so cool. Alright, now if you could just stand on the opposite side of the room and make it stop.
Cold breeze.
See, I think it's getting cold.
Cold breeze.
Is it?
And there's the two.
Like by my leg. Over
yeah.
Here.
Right.
Yeah.
Shine that light. Temperature. There's some over here. Take the temperature right here. Like right by her, right yeah. Between their feet.
See, I feel like I'm feeling it right.
53.4.
Which the four would still be cooler though, because
yeah.
Of the fact.
Mm-hmm.
Well, see, if he's feeling
that
chill on that side, then.
Mm-hmm.
I mean.
Okay, so.
So basically, me, Mike, and David went on the first team to go in. And we started on the west side, underneath the original Remington Town water tower. And when we were in there, it was like a base temp of like 60 degrees when we first walked in there. And I started asking some questions, and started getting K2 spikes pretty good. And we'd ask it to flash them, and they'd do it, and then we'd say to stop, and it would stop. And like to go from one side of the room and walk towards it really fast, and then step back, and it would just boom, 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 and then go back, and it'd be done. Now we send in the other team to investigate, and I'm hoping that they pull a lot more than we did, because if it is Aunt B that resides here still, then maybe the females, Sarah and Jamie, will draw some more evidence or more freaky stuff to happen. So we just have to wait and see.
What was the name of the lady that was supposed to be there again?
Aunt B is what they call
her. Yeah, they named her Aunt B because she has a bun in her hair.
They're not sure who she really is, so.
Is there a female in this room with us right now? We'd really like to talk with you.
Were you the one that took the wallet?
There's a little bit of cleaner, like over here. I don't know if it's a draft or.
I know, I can feel that. I feel like it's cooler in here than when we, Sarah and I, were in here.
Yeah,
but it's
mm-hmm.
Still the same degree.
It's just like this half. Like, I keep thinking it goes in, but I don't know. The tape recorder went off again.
You're kidding me.
Is there something you don't want us to hear?
Do you not want us in here with you?
Okay, so my group and I just came out of the garage area where the jail is, and basically we got a lot of K2 hits when we were in there. I don't know if Aunt B is really here, but we got a lot of hits on the K2, so I don't know what exactly that's gonna mean. I think we'll just have to wait and see what comes from the EVPs and see if we catch anything with that.
It's looking right at the floor. Oh, there you go.
Whoa.
Red
light? Yeah, it was a red light. I did a sweep in here too, and I didn't get nothing.
Is there someone else in here making this light light up for us?
No, maybe not.
You do it again?
Keep doing it.
Light up four. You got three, do four. If you don't do four, I'm not going to believe it's you. Please, could you light up four? What is it? This different?
That's what it is, like a heartbeat.
This one's not the other person.
There it is. How's it picking up? Oh, stop. Here's just nothing up there at all. Mine was like red. I did a sweep in here too, man.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Really?
And now all of a sudden you're getting stuff.
Was it like one in the morning? It's almost one in the morning.
Make them go off again. Make those lights light up again. Sit down here next to us.
You can sit right on top of these things if you'd like. Alright, so we just came out of the main room out there, and basically all night we've been getting K2 hits, and we've been getting a lot of good responses from the questions we were asking, so hopefully we're just not getting random hits from, you know, surrounding electrical wires and stuff in the building. So hopefully later, maybe when we go over our evidence, we can maybe get some EVPs pulled off our digital recorder. So, but like I said, we won't find out till later, so we'll see.
Today, we were at the Remington Water Tower, my daughter and I, Samantha. We went into the water tower part, and we had a K2 meter, we had an EMF detector, we had a thermometer, and we went in there, and immediately we started getting hits on the K2 meter. And we asked whoever was in the room to lower the temperature, and we went from 60 degrees down to 55. Which was really, really interesting for us and really, really interesting for my daughter. This is her first investigation. We continued from that room onto a small room next to it where all of the activity stopped. So we don't know if the entity that was in the actual water tower had stopped or just couldn't move to that part of the building. We continued from the small portion to the area where the residents of Remington used to pay their water bills, which is where they said Aunt B used to collect money for the townspeople. We had several K2 hits, and it was just a really great investigation for myself and for my daughter, Samantha. Did you have anything you wanted to add? Did you have a good time? All right.
The hell was that?
Door just opened up in here.
I heard that.
You've got to be kidding me.
It's a joke.
Yeah, I know.
It's in my case.
Where?
Right there, the green strap.
Oh, well, damn, I didn't even see that shit.
Yeah,
I don't know what to say right now. Mike, take it away.
Great. So, we heard there's some woman in here. I don't know what she did because I wasn't where I was supposed to be to get the briefing. Anybody else?
Okay, this is TJ's version of Greg.
This is your
heavy EVP session.
We're here now. We're not here to hurt you. Can you tell us if you're here? Okay. If you're a male, light it up. If you're a female, light it up. How old are you? Where did you come from? Can you tell us your name? 1980? You were here in 1980. Okay. 1980. What kind of car do you drive? Okay. Oh, did you see that? Did you see that? One me. One this. One this. All right.
I was to a T. As Greg Hamilton and ZBP special.
I don't know, there's a camera in my face. I'm not sure.
Don't look at me. I know you're just as bad as a female. No pun intended.
Well, good thing is.
Alright, damn.
We did get it. I lost the call.
Okay, we did.
We got it. Yes. Hopefully, maybe.
Yeah, Greg here.
Well, hopefully.
Give me a minute.
Bitch.
Big chuck.
Big chuck. A big chuck or something.